Good morning. Good morning and happy new year to everyone. Amen. First Sunday of the new year. Way to get it off started correctly. All things he has made new. Amen. Psalm 84, we were just reading in the back as the ministers were gathering together to pray together. Psalm 84, verse 1 says, "How lovely is your tabernacle, O Lord of hosts! To my soul longs, yes, even faints for the courts of the Lord. My heart and my flesh cry out for the living God." And then further on down in verse 10, it says, "For a day in your courts is better than a thousand. I would rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God than dwell in the tents of wickedness. For the Lord God is a sun and shield. The Lord will give grace and glory. No good thing will he withhold from those who walk uprightly." Amen. Anybody need some grace this morning? Anybody need some glory? Anybody need have a sun shine on your head? Anybody need a little shield about you? Hallelujah. Well, it's time to step in. Oh, yes, to the risen Lord. Hallelujah. Father, we love you. We come this morning and worship you. Father, we thank you that you make all things new. Lord, we surrender this whole 2019 over to you. We thank you, Lord, for your goodness, Lord, being unleashed in this year, Lord, in our life, that you're bringing transformation and change to us, pleasure in all things eternal. Father, we love you and we give you praise in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen. Let's worship him.
Darkness. inside. Yes, he's living on the inside. Christ in me, I'm being filled with Pentecostal glory. I am a dead man, but I've never been more alive. His fire's burning deep inside. I am a dead man, it's Christ in me. Sing it with me. And you are good, you are good, and your love endures. You are good, you are good, and your love endures. You are good, you are good, and your love endures. Let your glory come down. Every voice, sing it out. Thank you. let your glory come down. Sing it with me, fling wide. Fling wide the gates, open up your doors. Let your glory come down. Fling wide the gates, open up your doors. Let your glory come down.
We live for more. And we live for more. You worship, you pray, and adoration.
righteous Son of God. And I would sing, worthy are you, Lord. Yeah, yeah, da, 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 da. Yeah, but just begin to pour your affection on him this morning. Every voice raised in praise.
Yes, you can.
turn our attention, Lord. Turn our affection, Lord, to you. Our love, Lord, we turn it to you right now. We open our hearts. We turn our love and our gaze, Lord, upon you, Jesus. The author and the finisher, beginning and the ending. Fullness of the Spirit, Shekinah glory come.
Shekinah glory come. Release the fullness of your Spirit. Shekinah glory come. Shekinah glory come. Release the fullness of your Spirit. Shekinah glory come. Shekinah glory come.
Yeah. Just in your own words. Lift your hands right now. Lift your hands. Worship him. Worship him in your own words. Just go ahead and worship him. Just worship him. Worship him. Worship him. Worship him. Worship him. Sometimes you feel like worshiping, sometimes you don't, but worship him anyway. Just go ahead and worship him. Worship him. Thank you, Lord. You know, in our prayer this morning, Pastor Katie shared with us a devotional about coming to the well. She just said that you can come to the well and not drink, or you can come to the well and drink in. And so you've come to the well, you made it that far, you made it here to the well, to this gathering of our brothers and sisters in Christ. But it's up to you to have a drink to refresh yourself, to renew yourself this morning. Yeah, just to open up your heart, open up your affection, your love. Just like we were talking about last week, open wide, an expansion, a spiritual expansion of your capacity for God in your life. Or just take another moment, lift your hands. Ya 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 da na na ba, ya 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 ba da ma da na da ba, ya ba da na da. Deep is calling out to deep. Ay ay ya 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 ya. Deep is calling. Deep is calling out to deep. Deep is calling me deeper still. Deep is calling out to deeper still. Deep is calling out to you. And deep is calling out to me deeper still. Yeah, 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 baramane, yeah, yeah, ma baramamarene. I'm gonna drink my fill, Lord, at this well today, God. I'm not gonna leave thirsty and dry. I'm gonna drink my fill at this well today, God. You said if I'd open wide that you would fill me, Lord. You know, if I'd open my mouth, you'd fill it, Lord. I'm going to open up my mouth and drink.
Come down, here we are, standing in your presence.
precious to me, Lord. You are precious to me, Lord. Your presence, Lord, is precious to me. Your presence, Lord, is precious to me. Your presence, Lord, is precious to me, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Lord God, you know us. You know each one of us here, God. Lord, wash over us, Lord God. Wash over each one. Wash over the ones with a broken heart, Lord God. Wash over the one, Lord God, with a dry heart, Lord God. Wash over the one in fear or confusion, Lord God. And renew us, Lord, each one of us. Renew us, Lord. Jesus, thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We give thanks to you, O Lord. We give thanks to you, O Lord. We give thanks to you, O Lord. We give thanks to you, O Lord God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Y'all can have a seat. Thank you, Lord. Amen. So, I was thinking about a New Year's resolution, and it was to become more God-centered this year. To have a bigger vision, to see Jesus more like he is than what I thought he was like. To have the clouds cleared away so I can have a glimpse of his greatness and his kindness and his power, his generosity, his grace, his mercy, his holiness and purity and power, his almighty nature and his sovereignty, to see him, to know him, to see him, to love him. That's all it really takes to have to clear away the cobwebs. All it takes, is to see, have a clear vision of Christ. It's where it starts. It's where it all starts. It's where everything starts. It's where healing starts. It's where salvation starts. It's where, finding your purpose and plan for your life. It all starts and having your family sorted out. It all starts with the author and finisher of our faith, to see him again, to see him clearly. Amen. So, Lord, thank you for 2019. Lord, it's going to be an incredible year, Lord God. We have an expectancy in our belly, Lord, of things to come, anticipation. Thank you. Lord, just put your hand on your belly right now. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Awaken. Awaken. Awaken our souls, God. Clear away the Holloway glom from all of us. Clear it away, God. The cobwebs, the dustiness. Breathe the fire of your presence. Breathe your nearness. Breathe Jesus, Lord God. Lord, we can breathe that heavenly air, Lord God, that resurrection air. Lord, we can breathe, Lord God, life, 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 breathing into me, breathing over me. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, thank you for renewal, Lord God, today, for awareness, for passion, for expansion. Thank you, Lord God. One glimpse of your glory. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Amen. We're going to show a couple. We've got some stuff coming up. We're going to have some videos we're going to share with you. I wanted to mention this Wednesday, we have, once a month we have a gathering, and it's to pray together and impart vision over where we're going as a church. And this Wednesday we're doing that at 6:30. Actually, we have a meal in the Life Center. You can come enjoy that. And this Wednesday night, we're going to focus on prayer. We're going to spend a good portion of our time together. It's 6:30 to 8. We're going to spend a good portion of our time in prayer and just pressing into God and whatever it is that you need going on in your life. Pray and seek the Lord. Amen? So let's check this out, this video today. Oh,
17 people killed in a mass shooting at a Florida high school.
Most of them
most kids.
Can you hold me? Can you hold me? Can you hold me?
Please tell me I can be with you in school. I'm so sorry.
College provides biblical and practical training to ministers with a passion for revival and desire to impact the world with the message of the gospel. This spring, we are offering the following courses. Jeremiah and Lamentations, Mondays with Pastor Mark Del Corso. This course will survey the life, ministry, and message of the prophet Jeremiah against the background of the decline and fall of the Southern Kingdom. Revelations, Tuesdays with Pastor Frank Bailey.
I'm very excited this semester about my class on the book of Revelations. I'm going to be teaching on everything from the John on the beach of Patmos to the seven churches, to the throne room, to the rapture of the church, the great tribulation, the Antichrist, the return of Christ, the millennium, the great white throne judgment, and the new heavens and the new earth.
Divine Destiny, Wednesdays with Pastor Anna Donahue.
You got to take the past, get over self and say, you know what, past? Or whatever your thing is, you gotta quit identifying with it. Unless you're gonna use it to step on it, because you're so changed. Does the living, risen Christ live in you? Does he? If he does, you're royalty tonight. You're royalty.
In this 12-week course, we will identify how God chose the people he used in the Bible and for what purposes, and relate their lives to our own. We will then cover the three groups of spiritual gifts that the Apostle Paul teaches about in the New Testament. All classes are from 6 to 9 p.m. Monday through Thursday. For more information or to enroll, please visit our website at bethcollege.net or contact us at 504-733-5005.
You know, our world is changing rapidly all around us. And we shall not be ignorant. We have to focus on the Word of God. What is God saying about these last of days so we can have spiritual readiness and preparation?
I grew up in Victory my entire life. I was born and raised here. Growing up here at Victory really gave me a strong foundation for when I did end up going away for college for the past 4 years. And now that I'm back, I'm excited to be back plugged in and see what God's doing in the new season that He has for my life.
I never knew how real the Lord was, and I was going through some things at the time, and we came here, and you know, the Lord really opened up my eyes being here. The teaching is real good here. Pastor Frank brings a good message every Sunday. Being here since that time, the Lord has really impacted my life. I used to always want to go out on Sunday and go to the clubs and go out partying, and now all I want to do is come here to church. And so my kids love it here. Now I'm in the Bible college and joining the small groups, and really encouraged me through hard and difficult times. And I'm just really excited for the future of being here at Victory. I'm just so grateful and thankful for the family that's here.
Awesome. Thank you, Lord. Yeah, we're celebrating 40 years. We have our 40th celebration coming up just a few weeks from now, actually February the 3rd. And we have, we have an anniversary gala. It's going to be at Chateau at the Grand Ballroom there. And get your tickets because they're all going to sell out and you won't be able to go. They're on sale now at that back table back there. Amen. I want to share the scripture with you this morning. And beginning to focus my attention and my personal life on the person of Jesus revealed in the book of Revelation. And that's what we're going to talk about today, Christ revealing himself in the book of Revelation. And I'm going to share with you, before we do the tithes and offering, this first verse in Revelations 1:8. Just think about this. I want just close your eyes for a minute and try to imagine yourself, John the Apostle. I was in the Spirit on the Lord's day. I was in the Spirit on the Lord's Day. He was by himself, solitary beach, just seeking the Lord, praying in tongues. And suddenly, the atmosphere changed where he was. Suddenly, he was aware of God. And Jesus was standing there looking at him and began to reveal himself to him in a new way. And he said, I am the Alpha and the Omega, says the Lord God, who is and who was and who is to come, the Almighty. You know, what a start to the book of Revelations, the last book of the Bible. He's the Alpha, the beginning of all things. Everything that is came from Alpha. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. All things were made through him, and without him was not anything made that was made. He's not only the creator, he's also the source of redemption, healing, deliverance, provision, and renewal. Anything that he's the source of all of that. Every good gift comes from above and keeps coming continually. He's an overflowing fountain of life. He's also the Omega. Everything consummates in him. He will finish everything he has started. He's also the cause. Everything exists to display his glory. From moonbeams to rainbows, from earthquakes to volcanoes, everything that is displays his attributes. We see his beauty in the sunsets, his power in the splitting of an atom, his creativity in the smallest things like ears, noses, and fingers. Only the fool has blind eyes, not able to see the glory of God all around us. Now here's a short quote. I love this from Jonathan Edwards on today's verse. And when God is so often spoken of as the last as well as the first, and the end as well as the beginning, what is meant, or at least implied, is that he is the first efficient cause and fountain from whence all things originate. So he's the last final cause for which they are made, the final term to which they all tend in their ultimate issue. This seems to be the most natural import of these expressions. And the manner is observable in which God is said to be the last to whom and for whom are all things. 'Tis evidently spoken of as meet and suitable thing, a branch of his glory, a meet prerogative of the great, infinite, and eternal being, a thing becoming the dignity of him who is infinitely above other beings, from whom are all things and by whom they all consist, and in comparison with whom all other things are as nothing. As we end one year and enter another, we can be encouraged from today's verse. I am the Alpha and the Omega. He will lead us in the beginning of this year with his promises of new beginnings. He will strengthen our hearts as his declaration that he is Omega. He will watch over every day of the year from the first day until the final day to guarantee that his promises will be realized. You know, I love to think of the Lord is the source of all things, but not only the originator, but the continual source of all things. He's a continuing, flowing stream of life. He's a continual flowing stream of provision. He's a continual flowing stream of everything that all of us long for. Whatever it is that your heart is longing for this year, it's flowing out from God. Flowing out and flowing out and flowing out. He's giving and giving and giving and giving and giving. I've just, my response is to open up my eyes, open up my heart, and drink in deeply of his greatness, of his goodness, of his resources, of his creativity, and then begin to respond back to him for his glory. It comes from him, then it goes back to him for his glory. Amen. So he's provided for you in 2018. Can somebody say amen? Amen. Did he provide for you in 2018? Amen. 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 Is he providing for you at the beginning of this year? Will he provide for you the rest of this year? Amen. And so our response when we come into the house of God is to worship him and to worship him with our giving, to respond back to the Lord. Say, thank you, Lord, thank you, thank you, thank you. I don't have enough words to say. I don't have big enough words to say thank you for your favor upon my life, upon my family, upon my church, upon my community that I'm part of. Thank you, Lord. Lord, I thank you for all your abundance that you've poured into my life, and I want to give back. I want to sow back because I know there's more and more and more. You're loading me. Woo! You're loading me, Lord. Say that with me. You're loading me. You're loading me. Say it again. You're loading me with benefits in 2019. Oh, Lord, I praise you. You are loading me. You're loading my life with benefits in 2019. Lord, I thank you, Lord God, that you anoint my head with oil. My cup is overflowing. Goodness and mercy are following after me all the days of my life. And Lord, I give back. I respond to you in faith at the beginning of this year. What kind of year do you anticipate in 2019? What kind of year do you see? What do you see as far as God's hand upon your business, upon your finances, upon the work of your hands in 2019? Is it a year of expectancy in your heart? Let's start this year by sowing in expectancy, sowing in faith. Amen. Somebody say, sow in faith. Amen. Sow in faith and reap in mercy. Hallelujah. Lord, we thank you for this chance today to bring back into the house of God, to give back. And Lord, we thank you for this. Lord, we bring our tithes and our offerings into the house of God today with joy in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen, y'all. Let's give to the Lord. Thank you, Lord. Would you come? Let's stand together, y'all. Let's stand together and pray. We praise you, Jesus. We praise you, Jesus. Sia corete, kia borocote, kia batarasteke, biasteke mendea. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Just before I share from the Lord, I want to just take a minute and do this. Y'all keep praying with me. I want to pray specifically for anyone that's getting ready to have some sort of a medical procedure. I want you to come up to the front. There may be several of you like that here that I want to pray for you right now. Let's just pray in the Spirit. No need to look around. Just pray in the Spirit right now. Yeah, just pray with me in the Spirit, y'all. Come on, pray with me. Yeah, Ma, just stretch your hands out and pray over these that are coming to the front right now. Come ba 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 ndi ma ba nda ba re ke ba ram ba sti ke nde le be te ra 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 nda ra ra nda la 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 ra ra nda ra ra nda ra 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 nda la ra ra re re ya ra ra yo ro re ya ram ba sti ma ka re. Jesus, thank you for your touch. Come on, just pray with me, y'all. Pray with me. Viandama se cabaraste que basti, quem basti, quem debe, rebaste, que palabaste, que basti, que balabaste, que tabaste, que se cabaste, que basta. Cabana, cambala, baramba, salalalamaste, calalalabaste. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Jesus, sambaka la basta came back. Oh, sambasta, bala barra, manda basta, ke. Ko basta, ke baka basta, ke la banta. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Both of y'all? Thank you, Jesus. 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 You're the Lord who heals me. You're the Lord God. Le mama ma se ba 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 bre ma mando ro so ba te ba ba se ke ba ba randa bre stele bianda sta manda. Touch my brother, Lord, from the top of his head to the soles of his feet. Thank you for your healing. Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today, and forever. Touch from the top of his head to the soles of his feet. Healing virtue. Lamasa, healing river. Let your healing river flow, Lord. Let your healing river flow. Let your healing river flow, God. Yabrama se bababa se barandea. Yanda bar se rianda la la lamaste. Banda baramaste. Jesus, touch, 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 touch and heal. Touch and heal, touch and heal, Lord. La da 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 da. Let it flow like a mighty healing river. Let it flow, let it flow, let it flow, Lord. Your mighty healing river flowing over me. It's flowing over me from the top of your head to the soles of your feet. Healing virtue. Anoint my head with oils. Kama sambre mama. Strength and made whole. Thank you, Lord. Now, just everyone in this place, just lift your hands to the Lord. Lift your hands to the Lord, everyone in this building. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Life flows from you, Lord. Life flows from you, O Lord. Life flows from you, Lord. You said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. I am the way, the truth, and the life. You said, you're the light of the world. Lord, you said, if we follow after you, Lord, we wouldn't walk in darkness. Thank you, Lord, that you're like there's a river of light flowing out from you, God, flowing into us. Cascading light. Cascading river of light flowing into us. Flowing over us. Giving us understanding. Sing that little fullness of your spirit. Sing it again. Jesus, keep us, keep us, keep us, keep us, keep us.
Here we are, standing in your presence. Here we are, standing in your presence. Shekinah glory, come down. Shekinah glory, come down. Here we are, standing in your presence. Here we are, standing in your presence. Shekinah glory, come down. Here we are. Here we are, standing in your presence. Here we are, standing in your presence. Shekinah glory, come down. Shekinah glory.
Jesus, you're the Son of God. Jesus, you are the Son of God. I worship you, Lord. I worship you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. You can have a seat. And I'm just going to start by, I'm going to read the first chapter of the book of Revelations. You know, the Bible says there's a blessing just from reading this book. It's an unveiling of Christ. And you have to think about the context. You know, who is this character at the beginning of the story? Of course, it's John. You'd have to say John knew Jesus. If anyone did, he did. He was his closest disciple. He was there all the way through. He saw everything. He was there the empty tomb. He was there in the upper room. And he was there when he ascended into heaven. He was there when he was crucified. He was there at the water baptism when he was baptized. He saw it all. He was there when he walked on water. He was there when he raised people from when Lazarus came up out of the grave. He was there when he turned water into wine. He was there when he fed the multitudes. You know, he was there when he was arrested in Gethsemane. He saw it all. He was there at the trial. He was there at the cross. He went through the whole thing. And now as years have gone by, and you know, tradition says they tried to kill John. He was the one of the 12 that was never martyred. And it wasn't that they didn't try. There's all sorts of stories about how they tried to kill him, but you know, you can't kill someone if it's not their day. You can't kill someone if it's not their day. It's impossible. And so anyway, he was on the Isle of Patmos. He still at least had one more thing to do, and it was to write this book. And he was, I'm just going to read it. This will be listen carefully, because this will be the very best part of the entire sermon right now. I promise you. If you think you can improve on this, I've got a psychiatrist phone number I can give you. The revelation of Jesus Christ, which God gave him to show to his bondservants, the things which must soon take place, and he sent and communicated it by his angel to his bondservant John, who testified to the word of God and to the testimony of Jesus Christ, even to all that he saw. Blessed is he who reads and those who hear the words of the prophecy and heed the things which are written in it, for the time is near. Everyone say, the time is near. John, to the seven churches that are in Asia, grace to you and peace from him who is and who was and who is to come, and from the seven spirits who are before his throne, and from Jesus Christ, the faithful witness, the firstborn of the dead, and the ruler of the kings of the earth, to him who loves us and released us from our sins by his blood. And he's made us to be a kingdom, priest to his God and Father. To him be the glory and the dominion forever and ever. Amen. Behold, he's coming with the clouds, and every eye will see him. Even those who pierced him and all the tribes of the earth will mourn over him. So it is to be. Amen. I am the Alpha and the Omega, says the Lord God, who is, who was, and who is to come, the Almighty. I, John, your brother and fellow partaker in the tribulation and kingdom and perseverance which are in Jesus, was on the island called Patmos because of the word of God and the testimony of Jesus. I was in the Spirit on the Lord's day, and I heard behind me a loud voice like the sound of a trumpet saying, write in a book what you see and send it to the seven churches, to Ephesus, to Smyrna, to Pergamum, to Thyatira, to Sardis and Philadelphia and to Laodicea. And then I turned to see the voice that was speaking with me, and having turned, I saw seven golden lampstands. In the middle of the lampstands, I saw one like a son of man, clothed in a robe reaching to his feet, and girded across his chest with a golden sash. His head and his hair were white like wool, like snow, and his eyes were like a flame of fire. His feet were like burnished bronze, which he had been made to glow in a furnace, and his voice was like the sound of many waters. In his right hand he held seven stars, and out of his mouth came a sharp two-edged sword, and his face was like the sun shining in its strength. Couldn't even look at it. You can't look at the sun shining in its strength. When I saw him, I fell at his feet like a dead man. And he placed his right hand on me, saying, do not be afraid. I am the first and the last and the living one. And I was dead. And behold, I am alive forevermore. And I have the keys of death and of hell. Therefore, write the things which you've seen and the things which are and the things which will take place after these things. As for the mystery of the seven stars which you saw in my right hand and the seven golden lampstands, the seven stars are the angels of the seven churches, and the seven lampstands are the seven churches. Now you think about this incredible book. I mean, you read this book, it's filled with visions and pictures, glimpses into, from John's perspective, into things to come. Glimpses into heaven, glimpses into the prophetic events that are unfolding in our world around us. But it all started with something. Like everything else that's spiritual has to start. It's not by accident that this incredible revelation that goes on for 22 chapters of incredible visions from the Lord, it's not a coincidence that it all started with a glimpse of Him. That's where it starts. That's where everything that you're looking for will start. If you're looking for purpose in your life, it starts with a glimpse of Jesus. If you're looking for deliverance from some sort of substance abuse or alcoholic bondage in your life that you haven't quite admitted that you have yet, you'll find it at the feet of Jesus. If you're looking for the reason that you happen to have the talents that you have, you're going to find the solution and the answer to that question, that dilemma in your life, at the feet of Jesus. If you want to find out what your business is about, you'll find it when Jesus walks into the room. If you want to find the answers to the dilemmas in your family or in your ministry, you'll see it when Jesus walks into the room and you see Him for yourself. I'm telling you, He's available to all of us. He's available. What does it take? All it takes is a hunger for God. All it takes is coming to the place where you recognize, oh God, I'm in need, and what I'm in need of is You. I need You. I need Your fullness. I need Christ. I need a glimpse of Your glory. I need to see just a little smidgen of what John saw that day on the Isle of Patmos. Would You walk into my room? Would You begin this new year, Lord, with a glimpse of who Jesus is? I want to see Jesus. I want to know Jesus. I want to hear Jesus. I want to be surrounded by Jesus. I want His touch on my life. I want His presence in my church. I want His touch on my ministry. I want His touch on everything that I say and do. I want to find His favor and pleasure in my life. I want to hear Him say, well done, good and faithful servant. I want to feel His love surrounding me. I want to taste His joy bubbling up out of my soul. I want to see Jesus. I want to know Jesus. I want to walk with Jesus. Oh no, I don't want to just attend church casually on Sunday. I don't want to just be kind of maybe reading through my Bible to get it done. I want to see Jesus. I want to see Jesus when I go through the Word of God in my private devotions. I want to see Jesus when I go to the house of God. I want to see Jesus when I go to home group with my brothers and sisters, even in those goofed up people that I meet with week after week. I want to see Jesus. I want to see Him in their smiles. I want to see Him in their problems. I want to see Him in ministry. I want to see Him in the homeless. I want to see Him in the sick person in the hospital. I want to see Him in the prisoners at prison. I want to see Him in my neighbors. I want to see Him all around me. I want to see Jesus. I don't want to be glommed over with this world. I want to see. I want to hear. I want my emotions to be opened. I want to know Him. I want Him to come down and invade my little world, my comfort zone. I want Him to get right up in my area. I want to see His face. I want to smell Him. I want to smell His nearness. I want to sense His nearness in my life. I don't want to just live off of some creed that I've been taught, some system of beliefs that I've embraced. I want to know Him. I want to feel Him next to me. I want to feel His heartbeat when I open the Bible and read the Word of God. I want to feel Him when I come into church, beating in the songs. I don't want to be a casual observer, Lord. So it starts off, you know, I never noticed before as I began to read the book of Revelation, how He revealed Himself with incredible titles. I wrote them down actually in the back of my Bible because I hadn't seen them before like this. But this is, in the book of Revelation, He reveals Himself as the faithful witness. He reveals Himself as the firstborn from the dead. He reveals Himself as the ruler of the kings of the earth. He reveals Himself as the Alpha and the Omega. He reveals himself as the one who was and who is and who is to come. He reveals himself as the first and the last. He calls himself the Amen. He calls himself the faithful and true witness. He calls himself the beginning of God's creation. He calls himself the Lion of the tribe of Judah. He calls himself the Root of David. And he calls himself the Lamb who was slain. He calls himself the King of the nations and the Lord God Almighty. He calls himself the Word of God, the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last, the beginning and the ending. He calls himself the Root and descendant of David and the bright and morning star. He calls himself by all those titles in these 22 short chapters of the book of Revelation. Why? He wants us to know him. He wants us to want him. Oh no, not just, oh, I prayed the prayer and now I'm good. He wants us to know him. He wants our heart to beat with the passion to beat for him. He doesn't want lukewarmness. He said it in Revelation 3. He says, I don't want you to be lukewarm. He doesn't want he doesn't want my heart to be cold and apathetic. He wants me to be hot. He wants my heart to be hot, inflamed with passion. He wants to light that fire in my belly again. Am I offending you? I hope not. I'm offending myself. Oh, when he walks into the room, everything changes. Oh, yeah. Has he walked into your room lately? Come on now. I want to look at this first name that he calls himself in the beginning of this book. Revelation 1, 4, and 5. John, to the seven churches that are in Asia, grace to you and peace from him who is and who was and who is to come, and from the seven spirits who are before his throne, and from Jesus Christ, the faithful witness. Everyone say the faithful witness. He is the faithful witness. Jesus is the faithful witness of any person. Now, remember, we have to get our minds around this. He's not only the Son of God, he's also the Son of Man. He is a man, but he's the only one that can say that he's witnessed everything from eternity with his Father. He's the faithful witness and has been before there was a heaven and earth and a universe. He's the originator of all things, and he is the witness, the faithful witness of all things. Yeah, his eye is on the sparrow, and I know he watches me too. John said it in John 1:18 that no one had seen God, but Jesus had declared or explained him. No one has seen him, but Jesus, the person of Jesus, declared by his birth, by his life, by his ministry, by his healings, by his miracles, by his death, by his resurrection. His whole life is a declaration. Come and see the Father. Look at the Father in me, in my words, and in my actions. I am the faithful witness. Jesus is the Father's revelation or declaration of himself. There could be no greater witness. He's the Father's word expressed in a distinct person. If you want to know me, God says, you can see me in creation. You can see my attributes all around you. But if you really, 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 really want to know me, look at my Son. If you really want to know me. If you want, take a look at my Son. If you've seen me, Jesus said, you've seen the Father. Take a look. Take a look at Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John again. Get on your knees and read the Gospels one more time. Let the Word penetrate your heart. Let His presence permeate your life. Fall in love with Jesus again. He's the Father's Word expressed in a distinct person. This is where our understanding of everything that pertains to life begins, with an unveiling of Christ Himself. In His light, we see light. He is the light of life. That's why Revelation begins with John having a new revelation of Christ. If John needed a greater glimpse of Jesus, what about me? Here's how Matthew Henry talked about this verse. He is a person. the Son of God, the only begotten Son of God, and such he must have the same nature. This personal distinction always supposes one and the same nature. The person of the Son is the glory of the Father. The person of the Son is the glory of the Father. He is the glory of the Father, shining forth with a truly divine splendor as the beams or effulgent emanations of the Son, the Father, the fountain of light. Jesus in his person is God manifest in the flesh. He is the light of light, the true Shekinah. Shekinah glory come. He has come in the person of Jesus. Shekinah glory come. When he walks into the room, we glimpse the glory of the Father. The person of the Son is the true image and character of the person of the Father. Being of the same nature, he must bear the same image and likeness. In beholding the power, wisdom, and goodness of the Lord Jesus Christ, we behold the power, wisdom, and goodness of the Father. For he hath the nature and perfections of God in him. Yeah, I must say, to understand the book of Revelations, we must have a revelation of Christ. It's in seeing him that we begin to understand and see the things to come. In the beginning of this new year, I need a greater revelation of Christ as I begin this new year. This is where we see God's plan unfolding before us. It flows out of him. It's a revelation that flows out of him. In his light, I see light. In his light, I see light. Do you get it? In his light, I see light. Blind men can't see anything until the light opens their eyes, and then they begin to behold the world through this light that's been given to them. We can see what tomorrow's about. You can understand the mysteries of 2019 in your life as they unfold before you from the light that shines from the Father and shines out into your worlds. Does the future look dark and scary? Step into the light of his love. He's declaring Jesus. He's unveiling Jesus. He's unveiling his purposes and plans. He's unveiling his blessings and his promises for 2019. They're flowing from him into me, and then I behold his glory as I look around. This is where we see God's plan unfolding before us. He also calls himself, I'll give you just a couple of, I want to just whet my appetite, your appetite this morning. Hungry, Lord God. Make me hungry, God. Make me hungry, God. Hungry. Revelations 5, another glimpse. One of the elders said, now these elders aren't just any elders. These are the ones that are stuck to the ground around the throne, elders. They've been seeing something. They've been seeing the glory manifest by the seraphim, the burning ones, right there in the midst of all the action. If you want to get near the action, that's where the action is. You know, people like to get near the action. Well, that's where the action is. Yeah. Have you ever been to a basketball game? It's one thing to sit on the nosebleed section, and it's another thing to have your feet on the wood on the floor in those seats. It's a whole different perspective. It's a whole different world. And when you get in close, it's a different perspective of life. These are one of the elders said, weep no more, John. John was weeping because there was this scroll that couldn't be opened. No man was found worthy to open the scroll. And John was weeping and weeping. And the elder said, don't weep anymore. We found a man that can open it. Behold, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the root of David. He has conquered so that he can open the scroll and the seven seals. Between the throne and the four living creatures and among the elders, I saw a lamb standing as though it had been slain with seven horns and with seven eyes, which are the seven spirits of God sent out into all the earth. Here's a little snippet part of one paragraph out of this sermon that affected my life about 15 years ago. Totally. Have you ever been slammed by the word of God? I was slammed so hard by this. But here's just a glimpse. Christ, as he is God, is infinitely great and high above all. Infinitely. Everyone say infinitely. He's infinitely great and high above all. He's higher than the kings of the earth, for he's the King of kings and Lord of lords. He's higher than the heavens and higher than the angels of heaven, because he created them all. So great is he that all men, all kings and princes are as worms of the dust before him. Find the richest and the most powerful. They're like the worms of the dust before this great one who sits on the throne. So great is he that all men are like worms of the dust. All nations are as a drop in the bucket and the light dust of the balance. Yea, and the angels themselves are nothing before him. If you were to see one of the angels of God, you'd be starved, you'd be struck dumb and on your face by their brilliance. And they are as nothing compared to the brilliance of Jesus. He is so high that he's infinitely high above any need that we have. He's infinitely high above any need that I have for healing or deliverance or provision. He's infinitely high above any of all of that. He is so high that he's infinitely high of any of my needs, about and out of reach, that I cannot be profitable to him. I have nothing to offer him. And above our conceptions that we cannot, he's above our conceptions. It's impossible for me to comprehend him. I catch glimpses by the Holy Spirit, but to understand this infinite, omnipotent one, impossible. It's what eternity is all about. The unfolding of this person before us. And yet, everyone say yet, he is one of infinite condescension or humility. Infinite humility. Infinite humility. None are so low or inferior, but Christ's condescension is sufficient to take a gracious notice of them. He condescends to take notice of beggars and servants and people of the most despised nations. He humbles himself. This great one that's higher, he is the Lion of the tribe of Judah, yet he is the Lamb of God slain from the foundations of the world. He's the highest of the high and humbled himself as a man to be lower than the low. And when we see him in heaven, when we see him in heaven, we'll see both of these aspects of who he is, Son of God and Son of Man, in his infinite greatness and his infinite humility. We'll see him as he is. It will blow us away by his power and humble us by his condescension, because we'll think that we're something until we see his greatness, and we'll think we're something until we see his humility. I'd never ride in a car like that. Oh, I'd never dress like that. Oh, I'd never be seen with people like that. No, he would, and he did. With the lowest of the low. With the lowest of the low. You know, at the expense of offending others again this morning, I've overheard, you know, in Starbucks, overheard fathers bragging about how the greatness of their sons. And I've done the same thing. Oh, my son's going to be the next starting quarterback at LSU. And blah, 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 blah. He's on the travel teams. And he's blah, 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 blah. When was the last time you heard them bragging about, my son is going to the nations one day? Amen. Lift up your ambitions a little higher. Oh, instead of having an ambition for him to be a great athlete or even president of the United States, to be the least of those serving in some nation as a missionary to the nations. Amen. Raise your standards, my brothers and sisters. Raise your standards. Our standards are raised when we see him as who he is, as we see his greatness, instead of measuring ourselves by those that are somebody in this world, trying to measure ourselves with the great ones in this world. We become fools. Rather than seeing his greatness and his condescension and it bringing us down low before. A revelation of his greatness and a revelation of his humility. Yeah, I'm not going to even scratch this, but I'm going to share one more with you. The Amen. He calls himself the Amen. Everyone say Amen. That means we're finished almost. Amen. Revelations 3:14. To the angel of the church in Laodicea write the Amen. He called himself the Amen. That's who he is, the faithful and true witness, the beginning of the creation of God. What do you think about when you think of amen? The word amen means true, certain, faithful. It means that he to whom it applies is eminently true and faithful. When he what he affirms is true. What he promises or threatens is certain. Himself characterized by sincerity and truth, he can look with approbation only on the same thing in others, and hence he looks with displeasure on the lukewarmness, which from its very nature always approximates insincerity. Amen. When I think of amen, I think of Christ's final word on the cross. Amen. It is finished. Amen. It is finished. Amen. Sin has been conquered. Amen. Sickness has been defeated. Amen. I have triumphed over death. Amen. It's finished in your life. All of my enemies have been crucified, have been defeated before me. Oh, all of the ammunition they had against me has been nailed to the cross. Amen. It is finished. Amen. Sickness and disease annihilated. Poverty is over. Sin has been squashed by the cross. Everything that's been aimed against me, all the weapons formed against me, barraging me, have been conquered. Amen, amen, amen. That's his name. Amen. That's who he calls himself. Amen. It's finished. Amen. It's finished. It's done. Amen. Now I have to repent for lying because I'm going to read one more to you. I have to read this one. This is my favorite. You know, this never dawned on me, so I'm taking you to, this is the way I always read anyway. I go to the last page and see what happens, and then I start over. I want to see where I'm going before I get started. So if you do that with the Bible, this is the very last prophecy in the Bible, the very last one. And this is what the last thing Jesus said about himself. I, Jesus, have sent my angel to testify to you. This is number 6 in the notes. I, Jesus, have sent my angel to testify to you about these things for the churches. I am the root and descendant of David, the bright morning star. The morning star. It's announcing, the morning star is announcing something. It's the announcing the dawn of a brand new day. Why did he finish Revelation like that? He said, this nighttime is finished. A new day is about to dawn. That's who I am. That's light that you've begun to see. The darkness is over. The new day, the day of the Lord, the eternal day is about to break in on mankind. I'm announcing it with my coming. When I appeared, when I became a man and walked this earth, when I died for your sins, when I raised up from the dead, when I took my place at the right hand of the Father as your mediator and heavenly high priest, when I return, the day begins. I am the bright and morning star. Let me read this to you. This is the very last name in the Bible attributed to Christ. Needless to say, I don't think it's an accident. Christ has appeared in these last days to bring light into our lives and point us to the glorious day that's dawning on our world. We live in the last moments of the darkness. We live in the last moments of the darkness. Do you believe that? The dark day is about to come to a close. The glorious day is about to break in upon us. As I was preparing for my Revelation class, I came upon several quotes about the bright morning star. The first is from Albert Barnes. Its place, the first thing that arrests the eye in the morning, might serve to remind us that the Savior should be the first object that should draw the eye and the heart on the return of each day. It's how we start our day, turning our eyes on Jesus. It's how we start our day. This connection of Jesus to the morning star reminds us to center ourselves every morning by turning our attention to Jesus. It's impossible to sustain your faith without a consistent daily time with the Lord.
Learn from the morning star and look to Jesus as we begin this new year. The next quote's from Jonathan Edwards. He's the fountain of that spiritual influence whereby this light is caused to shine into the heart. He's the luminary whence all this light shines into the heart. And therefore, he himself is the day star or morning star that rises in the heart. What else can you say? Light flows into us as we look to the morning star himself. Adam Clark said it like this: the bright and morning star, I am splendor and glory to my kingdom. As the morning star ushers in the sun, so shall I usher in the unclouded and eternal glories of the everlasting kingdom. Clark says that the morning star is ushering in the glories of the eternal day. All we can say is, come quickly, Lord Jesus. The last quote is from Matthew Henry. He's the fountain of all light, the bright and morning star, and as such has given to his churches this morning light of prophecy to assure them of the light of that perfect day which is approaching. This light that flows from Jesus is the light of prophecy. As we gaze daily upon the morning star, we can chart our course through the turbulence of our new year. The Lord is drawing close. This age is drawing to a close. Whatever you plan to do, do it now. Yeah, if you have some undone things, better not wait. Start doing it right now. Let's stand together and just reflect for a few moments. Just stand with me in his presence. Let's just stand together in his presence for a few moments. Come on, rest. Lord, we believe the Bible is true. We believe that John saw, experienced something that morning, that Sunday morning years ago, that affected him and affected his world and is affecting our worlds. Lord, there's something on these words. There's something heavy. There's a heaviness, a weightiness in these words. Come on, de meste kene. Lord, these are words of life, Lord God. They're not shallow, but they're powerful. Lord, these words are the very words of life. You know, three chapters into this revelation, John was speaking to the church. The Lord was speaking to the church, speaking to John, speaking to the church in Ephesus. And he said to John, he said, behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man hears my voice and opens the door, I will come in to him and have fellowship with him. Now, the mysterious, strange thing about that word, it wasn't, he was speaking to the church. That word was for the church. Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice. So it seems as if our life is a continual opening up our lives to the Lord. We're continually opening our hearts. It's not enough that I opened my heart to him that August Friday night in 1973. But what about this January the 6th, 2019? This Sunday morning. Can I say with John, I was in the spirit on the Lord's day? Or should I say I was in the flesh on the Lord's day? No, Lord. Kima sambate kaman brist kalambare kenesta. Lord, I hear you knocking. I hear your voice calling me in. I feel you drawing me near, Lord God. I feel your love for me. Lord, I feel your kindness. Knocking on my heart, knocking on the door of my heart. Come near my son, my daughter, come near to me. Come near in this day, in this hour. How is it with you as you begin this new year, 2019? How is it with your soul today? How is it with your soul today? Is there anyone here that feels like they're far, far away from God today? You feel like whatever that means, you feel out of touch. God seems far off, doesn't seem involved in the day-to-day of your life. Seems like just an idea, but not a reality. If you feel like you're far off from the Lord, I want to pray for you this morning. I believe God's coming near. I believe that's what this service is about. He's coming near. He's coming near. He's drawing near, drawing us near. Oh, yeah, He loves us to come near, to be with Him, to draw near to God, to let His love permeate our lives. Is that you, my friend? You feel like you're away from Him. God's far off. I want to pray for you. I want to pray a prayer in just a moment. If you want to be included in that prayer, would you just slip your hand up right where you're at and say, Pastor, pray for me. Slip your hand up high right now. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Lift them up high. Anyone else? Yeah, yeah, yeah. Everybody praying with me. Yeah, 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 yeah. Yeah, yeah. God bless you. Anyone else? Lift your hand up high. You're not certain where you are with the Lord. You feel like you're far off. Today can be the beginning of a brand new life for you, my friend. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. The band's going to begin to sing a song. If you raise your hand, I'm going to ask you to slip out of your chair or your seat. Come stand right up here. Let me pray with you, pray for you. If you didn't raise your hand, but you feel that tugging, you know today's the day to make peace with God. You feel far off. Come join these others. Come right now. 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 Yes, Lord, I need you in my life, Lord. Come now.
More than yesterday, I need you, Lord. Yeah, more than words can say, I need you more than ever before. I need you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. You feel that tugging in your heart. Come join these others. Come right now. You feel like you're away from God. Today's the day. Today's the day to draw near. Come now. Come now.
More than yesterday, I need you more. Yeah, more than words can say, I need you more.
Thank you, Lord.
Than ever before, I need you, Lord. I need you, Lord.
You feel that tug in your heart. I want you to just slip out of your pew. Come join these others that have come to the front. This is the beginning of a new walk with the Lord in your life. The old stuff is going to begin to pass away. A new day is beginning to dawn into your life. A new day, a day of light, is going to break into your life. You need to yield yourself. It's a step of faith. I know it's difficult to walk forward, but this is how it starts. You have to take a step of faith. It's like taking a radical step in your life, leaving behind whatever it is that you've been in dealing with, and just step into this new light. He's calling you into fellowship. He's calling you to Himself. If you raise your hand and you haven't come yet, you've been, make your way to the front. Come right now. If you know someone that needs to be up here, go get them. As Chandler's singing, go get them and say, I'll go with you. Let's go to the front. It's time to make peace with God. Come now, my friend. Come now. Don't wait for another day. This is your moment. Come join these others right now. Come now.
More than yesterday, I need you more.
More, Lord, in my life.
Yeah, more than words can say, I need you more,
Lord, in my life, Lord.
Than ever before, I need you more.
More, Lord,
I need you more.
Sing with Chandler, sing with him. Come now, come now.
Yesterday, I need you more. Yeah, more than words can say, I need you more than ever before. I need you, Lord. I need you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. I want everyone in this place just to bow your heads with me. I'm going to lead you in a prayer. This is all about the heart. It's not about the outside. It's about the inside. I'm going to ask you to pray with me. But let this be your heart opening up. You're opening the door to let Christ begin something new in your life. Right now, pray with me. Heavenly Father, I thank you that your Son, your only Son, Jesus, became a man to represent me, to die my death, to take my sin in his body on the cross. Lord Jesus, wash me clean. I open my heart. Come into my life. Forgive me now. I thank you, Lord. My old life is finished. Your life begins in me today. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Father, I thank you for my brothers here. Lord, let your hand go upon their life. Thank you for touch. Thank you for change. Thank you, Lord God, for a new day, the day of the Lord dawning in them, in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Pastor Terrence wants to pray with you guys. With Pastor Terrence over here. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. You know, we have an awesome service tonight at 7 o'clock, time of visitation. Stepping into this new year, stepping in closer to Jesus, letting him unveil himself to us. Let him walk into our room tonight. Thank you, Lord. If you need prayer, I want you to just make your way to the front right now. I'd be happy to pray for you. If you're going through stuff or you need prayer, we're going to worship God. We're going to press in and worship God right now. Thank you, Lord. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Water you turned into wine. You opened the eyes of the blind. There's no one like you, Lord. There's none like you. And into the darkness you shine, and out of the ashes we rise. There's no one like you, Lord, there's none like you.